Good morning, all. How are you? Hope you all are doing good, right? So, children, in the last session, we have completed answer the following 10 question answers, is it? So, we have to continue the classwork notes in this session also. So, we have to continue the classwork notes in the same way, like the last two sessions, I'm going to show you the notes through PPT. So, you have to look into it and complete the classwork. Okay, children? So, shall we start now? Okay, children, in the last class, you have completed till question number 10, right? So, in this class, we are going to start from the question number 11, okay? So, start writing question number 11. Which are the city-states in Greek? I'll repeat the question. Which are the city-states in Greek? Answer, Athens and Sparta are the city-states of Greek. I'll repeat the answer. Athens and Sparta are the city-states of Greek. Okay, so Athens and Sparta are the city-states of Greek. Athens was an ideal city-state and had democracy. Okay, so Pericles' period started in Athens. So, his period is called as the Golden Period of Athens. Okay, Pericles' period is called as the Golden Period of Athens, as science, arts, literature and philosophy reached their pinnacle to height during his time. Pericles calls Athens as the school of Hellas. Okay, so next city, Sparta. Sparta was the city of Dorians and it was a military state. So you all know that the Aelians, the Ionians and the Dorians are the different tribes of ancient Greek, is it? So Sparta was the city of Dorians and it was a military state. Okay, so when Persian king Darius waged war on Greece, these Sparta and Athens rallied together and defeated Persia in the Marathon War. Okay, so when the Persian king waged war on Greece, these two states, city-states, Sparta and Athens, rallied together and defeated Persia in the Marathon War. Okay, so later a conflict arose between Sparta and Athens. After some time, there was a conflict between the Athens and Sparta. So, there was a conflict arose between Sparta and Athens. Finally, Athens lost and became part of Sparta. So, during this conflict, this Athens lost and became a part of Sparta. Okay. So, Athens and Sparta are the city-states of Greek. Okay, children. Now, shall I move on to the 12th question? Who is the father of medicine? Okay. Who is the father of medicine? Answer, Hippocrates. Okay. Hippocrates was called the father of medicine. I'll repeat the answer. Hippocrates was called the father of medicine. Okay. So, the spelling of Hippocrates, write it neatly, H-I-P-P-O-C-R-A-T-E-S, Hippocrates, okay. So, Hippocrates was called the father of medicine. Okay, children, next we'll move on to the 13th question, question number 13. Who are the ancestors of Rome? I'll repeat. Who are the ancestors of Rome? Answer, Romulus and Remus were the ancestors of Romans. Okay, Romulus and Remus. So these two were the ancestors of Romans. R-O-M-U-L-U-S, Romulus and Remus. R-E-M-U-S, Remus. Okay. So next we'll move on to the 14th number, question number 14. Name the philosophers of Rome. I'll repeat the question. Name the philosophers of Rome. Answer, Cato, Cicero, Seneca were famous philosophers of Rome. I'll repeat the answer. Cato, Cicero, Seneca were famous philosophers of Rome. Okay, so these were some of the famous philosophers of Rome. Okay, so copy down children, question number 11, 12, 13 and 14 neatly. Okay, next we'll move on to question number 15. Okay, so copy down neatly without making any mistakes. The spellings all should be correct. Okay. Next we'll move on to question number 15. So question number 15. Which are the two important cities of Harappan civilization? I'll repeat. Which are the two important cities of Harappan civilization? Answer, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are the two important cities of Harappan civilization. I'll repeat the answer. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are the two important cities of Harappan civilization. Okay, so this Dayaram Sanhi and Rakaldas Banerjee excavated the sites of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro in the present Pakistan, which is in the present Pakistan. Okay, next we'll move on to question number 16. Where can we find the Great Bath? I'll repeat the question. Where can we find the Great Bath? Answer, in Mohenjo-daro, a great tank for public bath, now called the Great Bath, was found. Okay, I'll repeat the answer. In Mohenjo-daro, a great tank for public bath, now called the Great Bath, was found. Okay, so children, the cities of Harappan civilization were well planned. Okay, they were protected by forts, wide roads, public wells, multi-storied buildings and well-planned drainage system are the important features of Harappan cities. Okay, so the drainage system is a great achievement of our ancestors. The importance was given to cleanliness and public health is a model for the present. Okay, so this system of town planning cannot be found elsewhere in the ancient civilization. We cannot find like this system of town planning in any other civilization. So this is an example. So in Mohenjo-daro, we can find a great tank for public bath, which is now called the Great Bath. Okay. So next we'll move on to the question number 17. Mention two reasons for the decline of Harappan civilization. I'll repeat the question. Mention two reasons for the decline of Harappan civilization. Answer, the reasons for the decline of Harappan civilization are, there are 4 points. First, the floods at regular intervals in Indus and its tributaries. The second point, द आर्यंस हु केम फ्रॉम आउटसाइड वुड हैव अटैक्ड देम. द थर्ड पॉइंट, ओवर यूज ऑफ वुड फॉर बर्निंग ब्रिक्स दैट डिस्ट्रॉयड द फॉरेस्ट. द फोर्थ पॉइंट, द स्प्रेड ऑफ इन्फेक्शियस डिजीजेस. I'll repeat all the four points once again. The first point is the floods at regular intervals in Indus and its tributaries. The second point, the Aryans who came from outside would have attacked them. The third point, overuse of wood for burning bricks that destroyed the forest. The fourth point, the spread of infectious diseases. So children, the cities of Harappan civilization began to disintegrate and gradually the entire civilization disappeared. Okay, so they became disintegrate, they began to disintegrate and gradually the entire civilization disappeared. So there were some of the reason. So there are many causes for its decline. So some of the causes are here. The floods at regular intervals in Indus and its tributaries. So there were floods from the river Indus and its tributaries oftenly. Okay. So this is one of the reason. And the second reason, the Aryans who came from outside would have attacked them. Okay, the Aryans who came from outside would have attacked them. So they might have attacked by the Aryans. So the Harappan civilization might have attacked by the Aryans who came from the outside. Okay. So the third point, overuse of wood for burning bricks that destroyed the forest. So they were cutting down the trees. So for the wood, overuse of wood. So they were using the wood for burning bricks. So overuse of wood for burning bricks that destroyed the forest. Okay. The fourth point, the spread of infectious diseases. So there were diseases which was spreading. Okay, so the spread of infectious diseases. So these were some of the reasons for the decline of Harappan civilization. So all the above reasons might have been the cause for the disappearance of the great civilization. So the historians believe that. So all the above reasons might have been the cause for the disappearance of a great civilization called Harappan civilization. So these are some of the reasons for the decline of Harappan civilization. Okay, children. So write down neatly question number 15, 16 and 17. So here we have ended with this chapter notes. Okay, so all the 17 question answers write down neatly without making any mistakes. So we all have completed all the three mains. Okay, first main fill in the blanks, second main match the following, and third main answer the following, all the 17 question answers. Okay children, write down neatly in your classwork without making any mistakes. So children, here we have ended writing all the classwork notes of lesson number 4, Ancient Civilization. Okay, so we have completed the classwork notes. I have given you all the three mains. First main fill in the blanks, second main match the following, and third main answer the following. So by this session, we are going to complete the classwork notes of Ancient Civilization. Okay, you have to copy down in your classwork very neatly. So we will see you in the next session with a new chapter. Okay children, have a nice day. Take care. Bye.